So today we are going to learn how to make a printed circuit board from a template and a diagram printed on a paper. To make this diagram, you use a laser printer, not an inkjet printer, and you make such a diagram, a circuit diagram. But how to make it is a story for another day. So today we are going to transfer this image onto this copper plate, and then you are going to use some chemicals, acids, to etch a circuit onto this template. We are going to transfer this image using an iron box, a normal electric iron box. A simple electric iron box to transfer the image onto the copper plate. Okay, when you're doing this, use the maximum setting on your iron box. You want it at the hottest setting. It needs to be really hot so that it can transfer the circuit diagram onto the copper template. And apply pressure like that. You apply pressure. You only have one chance to do this. Iron it a little more. And wait for the circuit board to cool down. Once you're done with ironing, you let the circuit board cool down. That is how it looks. You can see through it a little bit. And wait for it to cool down. So now we have this container, and we have the paper still on the copper plate. Now we are going to separate them, and we are going to use water. We are going to soak this in water so that we are able to separate the paper and the copper plate. You add water to the paper and the copper plate. And wait for about 10 minutes. When we have the board soaked, they are soaked for more than 10 minutes now, and we are going to peel off the paper and see if you have a good pattern on the copper template. Some of the paper will be left on the board, as you can see. As you can see, and you peel it off like that gently, do it gently, don't apply too much pressure on your thumb, and you will have a good board. Use a brush to clean the remaining paper, remaining pieces of paper. Make sure the board is clean, but don't scratch off the pattern. clean board ready for etching using concentrated hydrochloric acid. Well, this is the fluid we had used to etch another board another day. We are going to add more water and more acid, and we are going to use a solution to etch another board. That is the hydrogen peroxide, no, hydrochloric acid. A little bit of it. Do this in a ventilated room. You need a lot of ventilation. Hydrochloric acid is a dangerous chemical. Okay, we are going to now put the printed board into the acid and to etch it. You agitate it like that. For some time. And leave the acid to eat away the parts that are not covered by the toner. Continue agitating the setup, and as you can see, the copper that is not covered by the toner has been eaten away by the acid. Be careful with the acid because it is corrosive and can damage your clothes, your skin, or your eyes. Here we have our board. I have drained away the water, the acid, and now we are going to use some water to cleanse it. Remember not to touch the board. Here is our finished product. We have cleaned the toner off, and as you can see, the circuit is looking nice. Okay, that is for today. Like the video and subscribe to the channel.